Hey, hey, it is a brand new day. And once again, we've come to the Marbella Marina. The kids are already here. What a great way to start off the summer. Paddle surfing, sailing, everything you can organize from the Royal Maritime Yacht Club, which is at the main entrance, together with the Harbour Restaurant, which are both open to the public. So do pop in, particularly now that we're recording our Marbella Now TV shows here every Tuesday. Do come on in, say hello, and get yourself on the telly if you want to. We've got a great show lined up for you, so let's get this party started. The kids can't wait to start. Take a little look. My Marbella Moments column in the Euro Weekly News, I took the opportunity to write about people who are not on the town census. Now, I know a lot of people myself who, although they do spend quite a bit of time here in Marbella, albeit that they live in other countries some parts times of the year, they are in Marbella enough time to be on the town census. Now, the town census, what it does is say how many people are living in the city, and based on that figure, the central government allocates money to pay for cleaning the streets, policing, healthcare, etc., based on the inhabitants of the city. Therefore, if you are spending any amount of time in our city and are not on the padrón, there is no money to cover your health, your policing, your insurance, all these things that make our city clean and tidy. Now, a lot of people are scared that this means if they're on the town census, they're going to get taxed. And as they're paying taxes in their own country, they're very nervous about this. So I wrote my column in the Euro Weekly explaining that most of our looky people, to not say all of them, because I haven't spoken to all of them, but everyone I have spoken to is on the town register. Why? Because it gives them health care. It gives them all the benefits of our city, being able to use all the installations, etc. But there are no risks. They are not here legally. Therefore, if it was a risk, they wouldn't be on the town padrón because they'd be scared of being deported. As this is not the case, I hope this shows you that you will not be taxed and there are no worries of being on the town census. It is only positive for you and for our city. Thank you very much. The name says it itself. Knitted knockers. Yes, knockers that are knitted. And the lovely Maria Bailey is here to tell us a bit more about it. Maria, thank you. We first met at the United Nationalities of Marbella Summit.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming. No, and thank you for sharing this marvellous project. I mean, congratulations. What a beautiful thing to do.
Thank you.
Helping other people feel beautiful.
Yeah.
Which is wonderful. Maria, can I ask you first where you're from? What's your story? What brought you to the coast?
Right, well, I'm originally from the UK, from the northeast of England. We came out on holiday to Spain several years ago and just fell in love with the area and the culture and the language. We moved out in 2004. Homesickness took me back to my family a few years later because the family didn't come with me. But we came out again about 5 years ago and settled down. The reason I got involved with this is 3 years ago I had breast cancer diagnosed very early thanks to routine mammogram, which is a big message, has to go out to people, go for your mammograms. Had surgery, radiotherapy and everything, but didn't need a mastectomy, so very grateful for that. My mother had needed a mastectomy 10 years ago, and I was sitting on the terrace one afternoon, bored out of my tree, thinking, what am I going to do? There must be more to life than this. I'd taken early retirement. And I read a small article in the local newspaper about this invention, knitted knockers. Googled it, found out all I could, and I said to my husband, that's my next project. Little did I know I'd end up being president and everything that involved with all of that. But I'm the sort of person, if I do anything, I've got to do it right, and I've got to do it properly. And I was advised that to be taken seriously, we need to register, we need to become a charity. So that's what we did. That was 2 years ago. We've come on in leaps and bounds. And just to explain, a knitted knockers is, as you said in the introduction, a knitted breast prosthesis. The idea to form knitted knockers as it is now was by a lady in America in Washington State in 2011. She'd had a mastectomy and was horrified she had to wait so long for a silicone prosthesis even. And somebody told her that you are able to knit them. The feeling she got of having one of these in a bra, she just thought, I want all women to be able to share this. So now, 7 years later, there are over 500 groups in 27 countries around the world. And we are one of two small groups registered in Spain. We provide for the ladies of Spain and beyond. We are the listed as the suppliers for Morocco and Algeria. But if we get requests from anywhere, we will fill that request.
So the idea in the sense of you can, through the medical industry, get what would be normally this type of prosthetic?
Ladies are normally provided with one silicone prosthetic.
This is a lot heavier than this.
This is our equivalent. These are hot and sweaty. You need a special bra for these, which cost a lot more money. So these have a pocket that they sit in the pocket.
So that would go into the special bra.
These would just sit in your ordinary bra. There's no need for these.
So in this country, I mean, the sweat value on its own must be just the...
Absolutely. Well, one of the recent orders went out there just last week, and we had an email back from the lady yesterday saying, I'm in heaven, they're so light, they're so comfortable, and I haven't got a sweat rash. And I'd never thought of that before. And I thought, yes, this sort of thing next to your skin, hot and sticky, will give you a sweat. These are donated by ladies who no longer want them because they've discovered the benefits of knitted knockers. So these are made in 100% cotton. We make them to cup sizes, so, you know, different sizes. You put your order in as to what you want. The filling is non-allergenic. So they're 100% natural.
And they can be washed.
They go in the washing machine and can be used again and again. And we only use the best material. We used a Katia yarn, which is quite expensive. And people have asked me, well, try this yarn, try that yarn. But we tried quite a few different brands, and Katia is the one we use. We do use their logo on all our advertising, and they have supported us by giving us quite a lot of yarn when we started off. The beauty of it is, as well, is it's made by volunteers and completely free of charge to anybody who wants them.
Really?
So, for example, next week I'm delivering four to a lady who's had a double mastectomy. So we always give two, one on, one in the wash, you know, the way we would always do it. But if a double mastectomy, you give four. And the difference is... So
how do you stay alive then if you're giving these away? And I know you've got the volunteers doing the knitting, but you've got to buy the yarn. I mean, that's how do you stay alive?
From donations. We've been very, very fortunate in that the Lions gave us our first donation, couple of donations. And since then, people like Ali Mia of Costa Women has had a few events to support us. We've had a couple of donations from churches. We've had, there was a Sol Yoga group down in Almeria. They had a charity day for us, you know, 500 euros at a time we're getting in now, which really helps us to keep going. But we need to, the money come in so we can buy the yarn to keep the production going. And it's working well at the moment. But the biggest thing we need, apart from the money, is promotion, to get people word out there of what we supply, what we do, and to get ladies to ask for us.
Exactly, it's just knowing that it's there, you're giving them away, which is absolutely beautiful. People can give their time. Do you need knitters as well?
Yeah, we do need knitters. It's not an easy thing to do. They're knit on four needles, and we are quite particular. You know, it has to be tidy and neat. But yes, we can need knitters. But more importantly, as I say, we need ladies to come forward
awareness,
to ask for
donations
them.
And awareness that the people who need them
we
this is available.
We want ladies who've had mastectomies to have a choice. And you can't have a choice if you don't know. So it has to be an informed choice. So, and we're not saying throw that away. We're saying try these. Some ladies still use these for certain events or certain dresses. Some ladies prefer to use these, but it's all choice. But you can't make the choice if you don't know these exist. Okay. We also provide what we call V cushions or heart cushions for when people have had surgery and they literally just go under your arm.
Oh,
so it's that
you.
Support. These have been going like hotcakes since we've teamed up with a charity in Malaga called Asama, and they're specifically for ladies who've had breast cancer. They have a link with the local hospital in Malaga, so they go every time there's a breast clinic on, they go with a table. They now provide these in a pack for people who've had mastectomies. They have an information pack and they now provide our knockers in the pack, which is a big step forward.
Do you have people also that have gone around to speak, I imagine, to all the local hospitals and healthcare centres?
But what we need is to find a person in each of these places who will take the idea on board, because a lot of the doctors, the oncologists, are too busy. The ladies will whip them out, look what I've got, and they go, oh yeah, that's nice. Next, they haven't got time. So what we need to find is a dedicated nurse in these places who has got time, or a receptionist, even to have our information on display.
So you could do with volunteers for that as well, to just actually go visiting the places to find out who's the person in charge,
that's right.
To follow up on those type
of
things as well.
So that's another thing I need. More than knitters, what I do need is volunteers who will help me with the admin, help me with the promotion, because I do a lot of it myself. I have got a few ladies dotted up and down the coast. But for when there is an event, somebody else can go along and somebody else can take posters around and leaflets around. So if anybody down this area, for example, I haven't got anybody down this part of the coast, anybody's willing to give time, help with promotions, fundraising. I don't know marketing, I don't know fundraising.
So you need help in the Marbella area, San Pedro, to let everyone know. Well, we'll do our little bit.
Brilliant.
We
Thank
hope
you
that
very
you
much.
Will do your little bit and count on me for whatever I can do to help share the information.
Well, I'm sure this sort of publicity
will
help.
It's a good start.
Yes, well, that's what we need.
It's a good start. Like everything, we just have to keep it
going.
Keep everyone telling them. And if you would like to help Maria to get the information out, or if you would like to be an outlet here in Marbella, or to get involved with admin, administration, social media,
that's it.
Get the word out there.
There you go. And these, so though, we make these. These are mini knockers, little key rings, with a pink ribbon for the breast cancer. That's a gift to you.
Oh, thank you,
darling. To remind you of what we do and who we are.
I don't have a key ring. Now I do. And what a perfect one, because it is a perfect reminder that we want to keep our knockers.
Yes.
And that we should help everyone, be very grateful for what we've got.
Absolutely.
Exactly. Maria, thank you so much.
Thank
I'm so happy for you, proud of you.
Thank you.
And we women need to stay together, and you guys can help.
It's a sisterhood thing. It's
exactly.
Sisters helping each other, which is
hashtag
lovely.
Better together.
Absolutely.
Better make me knockers.
Yeah, I'm here in Marbella, but it says here I'm in La Canada.
If you haven't mastered the lingo, don't worry. Linear Director has a free GPS geolocator service that will come and find you. Spain is famous for its wines, and then in Marbella we have the most amazing restaurants that have selections of wines that we really do want to try. And of course, Marbella is famous for our nightclubs, for going out and partying. But it's important to do so responsibly, and I'm so delighted to say that a lot of our local companies have jumped on board our Zero Hero incentive. The idea is, if you're going out with three friends, if three of them are drinking and one of you is a designated driver, you shouldn't be punished for doing the right thing. And that's why I'm delighted to say that nightclubs such as Tibu and clubs as Babylonia, Portside, are giving this incentive all their support. Other places that you can go to, the Boardwalk, the Harbour, Beckett's, the Playwrights, the Red Chiringuito, the Urban Boutique Villa, the Hard Rock Cafe in Puerto Banús, the Kempinski Bahia Hotel, Cay Padre, the Mexican in the center of town. There are so many places that say, yes, please do come and have a good time, that they want you to go back many times. And the best way to do that is, step one, keep yourself alive. 147 nationalities all driving on the same 27-kilometer coastline. And so that makes it tricky to start with, but then we go out and have a drink. Maybe we haven't got all the attention with us that we should to make sure that we're driving to the best of our ability. Also, Linear Director Road Traffic Safety Foundation is supporting this with the breathalyzers that I'm going to get out now and show you one, because the participating businesses will be giving you one of these. And at the end of the evening or the lunch, if you blow in this and you haven't been drinking, you don't pay. Pretty cool, huh? It's a brand new day.